Okay, so I am sitting here with my, how many years have we known each other?
Almost 15.
15-year friend, Aaron Murakami. And we have just, we've had some miraculous moments.
There's been quite a few.
What's something that stands out for you that since we've met?
Well, early on, it was definitely being involved with the Equinox and stuff when you first introduced me to that, and a lot of the trainings that was, I don't know, it might have been around 25, 26 years old or so, and at that time, didn't really know anything about business or anything, and, you know, didn't have a lot of confidence to really go out and really believe that I can really do a lot of what I wanted. You know, I mean, I kind of had it in the back of my mind, but to really take it on, to where I actually really started living that I'm going to do what I want to do, and I want to, you know, accomplish things that I want to accomplish. It wasn't really until Bill Gould's trainings, through a lot of those trainings and seminars and stuff that we went to, that it really kind of stuck, and that was, you know, one of the most inspirational moments of my life, one of the most profound, and still to this day, I'd give that time period, you know, one of the, that's definitely one of the most influential times in my life, mm-hmm. and probably wouldn't have done it or experienced it if, you know, it wasn't for you, inviting me out to the office, and, you know, we'll do that, so it's very powerful.
Yeah, and we built a pretty amazing team together. It was really awesome working with you.
We did, and, you know, met a lot of friends, you know.
We changed a lot of lives, too.
We did, yeah. I think most it was a lot of people who were actually involved with the company and actually seeing the transformation that they went through when they're going through the trainings, seeing their lives change. I mean, there's a lot of people whose lives changed by using the products, really. There's a lot of people with allergies and immune system problems and a lot of this kind of stuff. You know, their products, their lives are definitely changed by using the products and that kind of thing. But, you know, when looking at the whole group of people, everybody we're involved with, look at where they are today. I mean, they're just, you know, doing their own thing. Most of them are not employed by somebody. They're running their own businesses. They got their own companies and that kind of thing. And that wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for us, you know, all working together back in the days.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
And you've done a lot since then. You've owned your own health food store. You've now I'm here working with you on a couple of projects that we're not going to say yet,
right.
But
pretty exciting.
So what do you think about this Dare to Live challenge? I know I just spent some time sharing with you how, you know, I really wanted to come and see everybody. It's been a few years since I've been home and wanted to, you know, create a remarkable moment with my family. And, you know, I've had a few people saying, you're crazy for leaving literally with $100. And, you know, what do you think about, you've known me for a while, about this journey.
Well, it's definitely been a while since you've been back here. Exactly 5 years. It was August 2005 when you were here and I was still working at the store. What it comes down to for me, and the way I see the whole concept of this Dare to Live challenge, what it basically comes down to, you're putting yourself in a position where you got to make something work, right? Leaving home with $100 to take a cross-country trip, I mean, that takes a lot of guts. Most people are not going to do it, and, you know, most people in their entire life are never going to put themselves in a position where they have to make something work, you know? If it's there's an easier course of action, they're just going to go along with whatever keeps them nice, safe, and comfortable. They had no way out. And so, you know, when you're hitting a road, even if you didn't get very far, you're in a tank of gas, you know, you're going to have to figure out some way to get back, right? Because, I mean, you probably drive several hundred miles and you're not going to walk. So what kind of things are going to come up? And it's kind of like, you know, I do believe in the universe taking care of us in an energetic kind of way, how things can synchronize for us. And a lot of times in our normal daily lives, we're in this rhythm. And when you get in a rhythm, things just kind of get entrained and established in this one way of being. And, you know, I see it happen probably more on road trips and vacations and stuff like that when we get out of our natural element. It's like we're throwing ourselves into chaos, and this chaotic potential that can become anything finds a way of aligning with whatever we're resonating with. And so it's a way to toss it up in the air and have it reorder and self-organize to basically have the universe bend over backwards and do everything for us in any given moment. You know, some people are going to call it manifestation or your law of attraction and all this kind of stuff. It's all pretty much working on the same principles. You know, I recently, in June, I was gone for 3 weeks. You know, got up and went and drove 7,000 miles. 3 weeks, drove from here down through Montana, spent a week in Fort Worth. Went down to Fort Worth, up to Roswell and you know, Grand Canyon and all these places that I've never been in my life and have always wanted to go. And, you know, if people really don't just put themselves out there, I mean, you know, I didn't do it on $100. I planned on spending X amount of money to go on this trip, and I'm going to spend this much on gas and money and everything else. And, you know, I didn't even spend half of what I planned on spending. Everything just worked out pretty good. And, but basically, when putting yourself in a position to have to do something, things will happen. You know, you've been sharing some of the stories with me about a lot of the amazing synchronicities and stuff and going through Vegas and these other things. And it's like, you know, chances are you would not have experienced things to that degree had you actually planned out the entire trip with a certain budget and everything else where it had to be a certain way. You know, mm-hmm. you left it up to a certain amount of potential that could probably be anything that you want. And it just finds a way of self-organizing for having the right amount of food and everything else just kind of falls together like that.
Yeah. I'm just going to leave a teaser here now because we only have so much time on this, but I know that we're going to do another tape. We're going to talk about, just share your three books that you've written. You're a published author. You have a huge energetic forum with over 80,000 members. Just plug the names of your books real quick so that...
The first one is called The Quantum Key.
Okay.
And it's basically a unified field model that I developed through, you know, not just sitting at a desk and reading what's the universe is supposed to work like. I actually do hands-on experiments with different electromagnetic technologies, but it's basically a model with no mathematics. Anybody can basically read it and see how it is possible not to only have abundance in our life, but you can actually make a machine that produces more energy than what you have to put into it. That means there's extra energy coming from somewhere, and that's the universe. And when we operate our lives according to natural principles of open systems, which is probably one of my favorite chapters in the book, people can really see that these laws of physics are violated every single time, and you know, every day that we live in anyway. The second book is called A Course in Mind Power, and it's basically, you know, also from personal experience. I have throughout my life had various experiences, natural premonitions, dreams of things that'll happen. I'll talk about them, I'll explain them to people, and then they'll see them come up on the news. Plane crashes, that kind of stuff. But I'm also a trained remote viewer, specifically technical remote viewing. And I got to a point where I was pretty good with that and high degree of accuracy and stuff. And so looking at a trained method versus what we're naturally able to do, plus a background in Qigong and stuff, with cultivating the Qi and really opening these channels to where we have more potential that we can access with our mind. I'm talking about this pure quantum potential that's a substance of thought itself. We can actually manipulate our bodies to cultivate that more like a capacitor so that when we have a thought, we're actually able to mold that potential and shape it in any way that we want. But that goes into a lot of exercises and different things that most of these so-called mind power gurus and stuff they never talk about. And the other one is a book I co-authored with my friend Peter Lindemann. He's one of the world's he's a world-renowned expert and one of the top experts on technologies. Been in the field for over 35 years in alternative research development. And we wrote a book.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard.
Cool. All right, well, we'll download this and we'll be back for more. Thanks, Aaron.
Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart. Like, why are we here and where do we go? And how come we're so hard? It's not always easy and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. And all of these moments just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between with only